Hello everybody and welcome to another Minecraft video brought to you by Rob's Mind, and today we are going to be looking at a popular viewer request down in my comments section, but first I saw it from EliteMean141. This is of course the general mob farm or mob grinder. I did design it to catch spiders and kill spiders as well. It is pretty efficient, pretty cool. It uses dispensers with water buckets inside of them running off of a hopper clock in the back, and will occasionally flush out all the mobs, pushing them to the center, drops them onto the magma blocks, and picks all the items up in kind of a strange way. There's a good load of mobs coming down into the kill chamber right now. So as you see, we got all sorts of mobs in there. They all just died on the magma blocks, and we'll go check out how I've got it set up to collect all the items. So behind these stair blocks, I actually have a minecart spinning in a circle with one powered rail and three unpowered rails. The reason I have the stairs there is because it absolutely drives me nuts to see this minecart going in circles like that. But as you can see right there, we got a decent amount of drops. That was from maybe, I don't know, 30 minutes of waiting or something like that. I had to kill a witch in there, saw a potion. But it's a pretty cool, pretty efficient farm. I designed it, I tried to make it kind of look not so ugly like most mob farms kind of do. But if we pop inside of this thing, you can just see that it's just layers of rooms, darkened rooms, that have dispensers in the corners, water buckets in the dispensers. Like I said, if we wait for a second, it should hit any moment now. It should go ahead and, yeah, I think it just went ahead and updated and fired the dispensers. So there's all the water pushing all the mobs to the center, just like that. And we've got it wired up, actually kind of cool. I've got it wired up right on the layers like that. The observer's staring at the hopper clock, and it just goes ahead and updates all of it all the way up the line with the observers. Right here, this redstone dust actually powers the block sitting on top of the dispensers, if you were wondering how the dispensers get powered. All of the observers are just staring at the circuit right there below them so that they can go ahead and fire on up the line. And as you see again, the hopper clock updates, it updates the entire system, and there we go, it's ready to spawn more mobs. So now we'll go ahead and show what we're going to need to build this. Right here, we are going to be looking at 6 glass blocks, 2 stacks of whatever blocks of your choice, plus 25, 6 hoppers, 3 regular rails, 1 powered rail. That's actually supposed to be 1 lever, 4 magma blocks, 1 hopper minecart, 2 sticky pistons, 1 redstone block, 1 observer, 2 redstone, 2 redstone comparators, 2 chest, 2 stair blocks, and 1 redstone repeater. And that is all the materials for the base, which is the tube, the collection system, and the first platform at the bottom. Now from the walls going up, oops, let me fill that back in. From the walls going up, this is actually the layered materials you're going to need per layer. You will need 2 stacks of stone bricks, or any block of your choice, plus 20 blocks. A trim block, I put that in there as an optional thing if you want this to be contrasted on the recessed part. 4 dispensers per layer, 4 water buckets per layer, 28 redstone per layer, 2 repeaters per layer, and 1 observer per layer. Now we'll go ahead and grab all of our items right here and start construction on the bottom layer of this mob farm. So I'll go ahead and grab all of these items as well. The first thing we are going to want to do is grab and place a chest. I'm going to place a double chest right here. I'm going to have 4 hoppers all running into the double chest, just like this. Okay, then I'm going to place 1 powered rail and 3 regular rails on the other 3 hoppers. So you'll end up with a format that looks something like this. Next thing I'm going to do is surround this with blocks. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my blocks real quick. I'm using stone bricks. You can use whatever blocks you want. Does not have to be stone bricks. So here we go. Building that up. I'm building it up three blocks right here. One, two, three. I'm going to place a lever right there on the second block and turn it on so that way the powered rail is actually on. Don't put it on the first block or else you will power the hopper and whatever is right there won't get pushed into the chest. So here we go. The next thing we are going to do is build this up a little more and put some glass on the front. Oh, and of course place our hopper minecart in there. So here we go. I'm going to place some stairs above this because, like I said, that will absolutely drive me nuts in about 10 seconds. And go ahead and surround all of that. Place my magma blocks to cover that so I never have to see you again. And then I'm just going to... I'm going to break those blocks in a second. I actually messed up placing those there. I don't know why I'm placing those blocks. But we'll just go ahead and keep building. See, there we go. Remove those. I'm just going to build up the tube. Just a few blocks. It doesn't matter how many you build it. I'm going to build it just three high like this. Or three more high. I guess it'll be six total. So just like that. Now you should have something looking like this, and we are going to start flooring this. The way we're going to floor it is I'm going to go one block up. I'm just going to go out four blocks on every side. One, two, three, four, plus two, one, two, three, four. It'll give us a total of a 10 by 10 area. So I'm going to go ahead and build all of this real quick. So this is how we should be looking here, and as I said, it will be a 10 by 10 area with a 2 by 2 hole in the middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So now that we know that we did that right, we can go ahead and build the walls. Walls are of course going to be too high, they're going to go all the way around, and we will have dispensers in all of the corners right here. So I'm going to have the dispensers on. You're going to pick two walls. I prefer to do it on the left and right sides of it as opposed to the front and back of this just because you'll... I prefer to have the hopper clock in the back of this, but it's whatever you want to do. If you want to see all the redstone in the front, then go ahead and build it that way. It does not have to be done in a specific way. But just go ahead and build the walls around it just kind of like this and place your dispensers just like that. So we'll go ahead and fill that in. There we go. Place another dispenser right here facing towards the middle. And fill in this last row of blocks here. Now, of course, you will want to place your water buckets inside of your dispensers right now. I'm not going to. I'm just going to show you how to start on the next layer, which will be the ceiling slash floor of the next one. So we're going to take a trim block. If you want to use a trim block to have it contrast, I'm going to just do one strip of this block all the way around, one block inside of this. And then I'm going to get my other block, which is, of course, my stone bricks. I'm going to build up my corners, and then I'm going to fill in all of this, one, two, three, and then the spruce wood makes four, so that'll be the start of our 2x2 hole right there. So we'll just go ahead and do that, just like this. Make sure that we are aligned, and we are. That would not be good if you're not. So we will finish placing these last few blocks in, and then we will start work on the next wall. And of course, your dispensers will be stacked on the same spot as your other ones were on this layer. So I'll just show you guys that real quick. And once we place our last dispenser, you are also going to want to place your water buckets inside of those. You will be pretty disappointed if you get to the end and realize you have to build all the way back up to fill all of your dispensers. So go ahead and put those in there. I'm going to build up a few more layers of this, and I will be back. I'm going to build up 7 layers, I think. Alright, so now we're back, and you should be looking something like this. I have 7 layers, but you guys can put however many layers you want, or like I say, however many resources that you have. I'm just showing that my water buckets are all in this thing, so we're going to... I'm going to use my trim block to go around this, and then I'm going to fill in the center all the way full of solid blocks. Having that completed, the next thing that you can do is spawn-proof the top. You can just go ahead and spam torches all over it if you want. I am going to go ahead and choose to use half slabs on every single block of this to make it 100% spawn proof and not hideous. Now that that's all done, I am going to go ahead and fill in the four corners of this with my stone bricks. Like I said, use whatever blocks you want. But there we go. We've got that all completed. And the next thing we are going to do is work on the redstone aspect of this. The first thing we're going to need to do is find the center of this. It is a 12 wide structure, so you are going to need to pick a side. I'm going to choose the right side. So we're going to break a block just like that. Put a piece of redstone right down here. An observer staring at the redstone. Redstone on the block on top of the observer, observer staring at the redstone, so on and so forth. We will repeat this process all the way up at the top. Do make sure that your observers are looking at the redstone and not looking somewhere else, or else this will not work. So go ahead and keep on towering this up, and right up there we will place redstone up here. We're going to place a line of redstone and repeaters on the end going into those two blocks. Then on the sides, we are going to place redstone going all the way across. This will be the same on both sides. So I'm going to go ahead and speed this up, and you guys can watch me do all of this. And hopefully you'll get the idea. So, now that we have finished that, you should be looking just like this around your build. And there we go. All that we have left to do is go ahead and hook up the hopper clock to go ahead and power our water-filled dispensers. So, the way that we are going to do that is by going ahead and coming to the block by our observer, placing a block with a repeater there. I removed that repeater, but you really don't have to. I don't know what I was thinking, right? I felt like it would mess up the system, but it really won't. So there we go. Place the observer there. Place a repeater right there. Then we are going to build out a little platform for our hoppers and the hopper clock. This hopper clock was originally designed by Etho. If I can remember, I will put a link to his channel down in the description. It's really a useful clock. I use it all the time. So here we go. We've got one hopper running into another hopper. If I can go ahead and get there. There we go. Comparators running out of each of the hoppers. Just like that. The comparators will then run into blocks. And then I'm going to place a block on top of that block so that we can place sticky pistons right there. Remove those two temporary blocks and replace them with redstone dust. Then you will place a redstone block on the face of one of the pistons, and whichever hopper is empty, which means whichever one is not covered by the redstone block, just go ahead and fill it with a stack and a half of items. So go ahead and go to this hopper, one stack plus 32 items, and there we go. We've got that all going for us right there. That's what we want. So now all the water is activated. We've got mobs already flowing down into this thing. I guess they've been spawning while we've been building it and stuff like that. So we've got that all going well for us. That skeleton seems to be getting hung up, but I have not had any problems with mobs actually getting stuck in here. So there we go. That is actually all that there is to this build. So if you did like this video, please do hit that like button. Leave me a comment, and please do subscribe to the channel. It helps me a lot. And also, if you have any redstone ideas or suggestions, go ahead and drop them into my comments section, and I promise I will be working on them. This has been Rob's Mind, and I'm out.